A grisly discovery in a Bullitt County apartment lands one man behind bars.
Detectives say they busted a stolen body parts ring where they found more than 40 different human remains, including skulls, spinal cords, and hip bones. Investigators say some of the remains were even being used as home decorations. Taylor Woods spoke with the man's neighbors, who say they're horrified by the disturbing finds.
When FBI agents this week raided an apartment in this Mount Washington neighborhood, they asked the man inside, James Knott, if anyone else was at home with him. According to the criminal complaint, he told them, "Only my dead friends."
He just lived right over here, so just really a shock and nervous now that something like that could be going on.
Neighbors are stunned. Investigators found 40 human skulls, spinal cords, femurs, and hip bones inside Knott's apartment. According to the affidavit, they were decorated around the furniture. One skull was laying on the mattress where he slept. Another skull was wrapped in a scarf. At the apartment complex, one neighbor posted this note saying, "We know nothing about our neighbor. Don't knock on the door."
Everybody is friendly. But you know, when I heard this, you just never know who your neighbor is anymore.
James Knott is believed to be part of a ring of people buying body parts involving a morgue manager for the Harvard Medical School anatomical program. FBI agents discovered a Harvard Medical School bag inside Knott's unit. They also found Knott going by the Facebook user William Burke on Facebook, where he shared several messages between a man named Jeremy Pauley in Pennsylvania. The two discussed photos and videos of skulls for sale. The FBI searched his white Chevrolet truck seen in this driveway. Investigators found a crate of 3 AK-47 op rod and bolts, 7 AK-47 empty magazines, and a drum magazine on the floor bed, 10 fully loaded AK-47 magazines with additional ammunition. Taylor Woods, WHAS 11 on your side.
Now, if convicted, Knott faces up to 10 years in prison.
Metro Police detectives have made an arrest in the I-65 road rage case that left a 6-year-old shot and in critical condition. Jonathan Rivera was arrested Tuesday night. Police say they found him Monday night with a gun near the scene of the shooting. Officers say some motorcyclists got into some kind of altercation with another vehicle before those shots were fired. Police say the gun on Rivera matched the shell casings found at the shooting scene. LMPD investigators are still trying to figure out exactly what his role was in that shooting. Now, take a look at your screen here. Police are looking for this man. They believe he stole $12,000 worth of items out of a car back on the 30th of June. One of those items was a handgun. Police say this happened on North First Street, right by the Roots 101 African American Museum. And, of course, the Humana Waterside building is right there. If you have any information about this man, you're urged to call the anonymous police tip line at 574-LNPD.
Another Kentuckian's charged with felonies for his actions during the January 6th insurrection. 46-year-old William Stover of Elizabethtown is charged with civil disorder, a felony offense. The FBI identified Stover in security footage from the Capitol grounds. It says he pushed against Capitol police lines and helped other rioters fight against officers to get to the entrance. Court documents also say Stover handed a police officer's shield to another person who used it to attack police. He appeared in court in the Western District of Kentucky. Stover's one of more than 1,000 people charged in connection to the insurrection. And we have an update this morning on the Shively police officer accused of speeding more than 100 miles per hour with his child in the car. Officer William Bors has pleaded not guilty. He's facing multiple charges for speeding, wanton endangerment, and official misconduct. He did not appear in court for his arraignment yesterday, but his attorney entered that plea on his behalf. The judge ordered the police officer to have no contact with his 1-year-old toddler. Shively police put him on administrative leave at the beginning of June. His next court day is set for the end of August.
Former mayoral candidate Shamika Parrish Wright has officially launched her campaign for the 3rd District Metro Council seat. Supporters gathered for her kickoff at Peace Park last night in Shively, which is part of District 3. Parrish Wright was not initially on the ballot. Louisville Democrats instead nominated incumbent Kamar Rashad. However, an attorney for Parrish Wright challenged Rashad's nomination, which ended up giving Parrish Wright the nod.
I think the controversy is not on my end. I did what I should do for my community is stand up and try to stand there and fight through it all and be the one to help lead our community in a better direction.
Currently, Parrish Wright's only challenger is independent candidate Jibrin Crook. The general election is November 7th.
Today, we will learn how the city plans to spend its first installment of money from the most recent opioid settlement. Companies responsible for fueling the opioid epidemic, like CVS and Walgreens, recently began settlement payments to Kentucky. In total, the state will divvy up $317 million between local governments and the Commonwealth. Mayor Craig Greenberg is set to announce the spending plan today at 11.